Hey folks, this is me, it's finally in part of the Kappa, joining with you from Bangalore, representing TPT4, India's emerging community sharing platform. We went around the metro city of Bangalore to understand public's perception regarding the recent interim budget, how it will impact the economy in the long run. Essentially, the questions were about the focus of the budget and will it be beneficial for the middle class and the agrarian community in the country who have been neglected by the policymakers for the past couple of decades. We interviewed a handful of people ranging from different aspects of the social life, students, businessmen and individuals who have gone through the budget document and tried to understand their opinion regarding this matter.
Hi guys, I was wondering if you could give us your opinion about the budget and what you think the impact is going to be.
So, as common people, I guess the best thing that happened is that they have lifted up the exemption amount to 5 lakhs, so people don't have to pay tax till there. But other than that, I guess my opinion is that the election is coming soon, I guess. So everyone's saying that this is just for the sake of the winning of the election because we haven't seen any much such changes, positive changes in the last past 4 years. So I guess, but I just hope for the best that it will turn out to be a good result for us.
Yeah, adding to that, the gratuity limit has been increased to 20 lakhs, what I have heard of, from 10 lakhs. And that's also a good move. And I've also heard that some like 6,000 or so will be given to farmers, or not sure about that. But yeah, that will also help the farmers. That's it.
So as for the budget, like 2019 came, it was given by the Piyush Goyal, the first CA in the history, the first CA is going to like has presented the budget 2019. So mainly focusing on the digital economy side, digital economy. So I've seen that the budget was focusing on like the previous schemes like Digital India, all those sectors. This budget is trying to boost those sectors. So it's not anything new, but they are funding. Like more funds has been arranged for the previous allocated things. So as we can see, like this budget, there's introduction of, like the Piyush Goyal said, like 1 lakh digital villages will be converted by 2030. For that, they are going to like establish common service centers. So this will help the rural areas to get access to the digital facilities which they were unable to get earlier.
So. Yeah, so I felt it was mostly on populist measures. You know, it was like to get the votes because they waived off farmers' loans and, you know, they did something to obtain votes, but they didn't harm the economy as such. They took a balanced approach to formulating their budget. Yeah, that's what I think.
So basically, after listening to the tax, the financial budget which has released on February 1st, the best thing which I liked was it was the first time in the history that more than 1 crore people have, means there are many people have shown that their income is more than 1 crore, which is actually a very big thing. Because if you notice, if you would have observed, then people do earn more than 1 crore in their as a salary, but that means as an income, but still they don't show that because they know that they'll be coming under audit, and that is going to be a huge problem for them because they have to maintain all their records and all these things. So after listening to this, I was really glad that many people have showed that they are earning more than 1 crore as their income. And apart from that, the tax bracket for high price commodity is also going to come down. And also the best thing was that the tax rebate was given only for people who used to have an income of 2.5 lakh and below, but now they have increased that bracket to 5 lakhs. So anyone who earns an income from 0 to 5 lakh will not be needing to pay tax. So that's the best part about it.
But like according to me, the tax bracket which they has increased to 5 lakhs, so basically it's very difficult for the government to cover the fiscal deficit of the country. It's already a lot of fiscal deficit is there. So by increasing the tax bracket to 5 lakhs, that 2.5 lakhs which they are not getting now, the tax on that 2.5 lakhs, so it's very difficult. Moreover, they are increasing their expenses and they are reducing their revenues. So I think it will be difficult for the economy to to cater to this budget.
Possible, but if you look into the normal consumer, if you look into the public's opinion, then obviously anyone would like to save tax as much as possible. So having a tax bracket to 5 lakhs is actually good from the public
it
opinion.
It has a pros also, but like...
But definitely the government would have not just given the tax rebate just like that. They would have definitely kept something else in mind. So let's see how exactly people take this thing forward. Thank you.
Budget 2019 is a well thought budget before the Lok Sabha election 2019, and I think it's mainly for the middleman and the youth and the farmers.
As we are about to become a part of the labor force now, and we represent the youth, so I think it's a really good strategy they have thought about. And the labor force, like the people who are newly employed, usually fall in that income category. So it's really a well thought thing, and it's going to help the youth mainly, I would say.
And moreover, the 6,000 per year which they have decided to pay to the farmers, I don't think that will benefit them that much, because that will be given in 3 installments in a year. So 2,000 in 3 months, I don't think it will benefit them to that extent. If they get the lump sum of 6,000 at one period of time, then it may benefit them. But 2,000 in 3 months, I don't think it will benefit to that extent.
Hi, so I was wondering if you could give us your opinion on what you think about the budget and what do you think the impact is going to be?
Yeah, I think the new budget that has come out, I think it's, as expected, a very populist budget, and they've done everything in their power by making things vague and not being very clear about what exactly it is that they're trying to do. And it's a nothing budget in my opinion, because it doesn't add on to anything. In spite of some tax slab changes and the reforms for the agricultural sector, I think it's been quite vague. But I mean, they've tried to get into the news and tried to get to the people that they're actually targeting for vote bank politics, as we all know. And that's my opinion on the budget, because I don't think any of us expected anything different, but this is how it is.
Yeah, present budget, which was introduced on 1st February 2019, it's mostly a common man friendly budget. It benefits the middle class people of our country, since they give rebate if your income is less than 5 lakhs. And also, if you're having equity investments and your income is less than 6.5 lakh, then also you need not pay any tax, which in turn improves the capital formation capacity in our country. Because if you're having equity investments, then you need not pay any tax. So it in turn improves the capital formation capacity in our country. In long run, the impact would be as it will widen the tax base of our country, as in many people will try to show their income, will try to file their returns, because they need not pay any tax. Even if their income is above 4 lakhs or 5 lakhs also, they need not pay any tax, since they are getting rebates. That's what.
Hi guys, so could you guys tell me what your opinion of the budget is, and what do you think the impact of the budget would be?
Oh yeah, we just read about that in the morning.
Yeah, so there was this one point which came out which said that there's a rebate on anybody whose income is above 5 lakhs per annum. So what I was discussing with her is the fact that most politicians or most people are just going to state the fact that their income is only 5 lakhs. So, like, probably most government officials would just say that their income is 5 lakhs and they'd want to take up the 5 lakh rebate, income tax rebate. So obviously there'll be constraints and there'll be other factors which will be affecting this, but that's something which caught my
mind. Anything else you guys have in mind?
Not really at the moment.
Thank you so much.
Thanks.
Hey, I was wondering if you could give us your opinion about the budget, and if you could tell us what do you think the impact is going to be.
Yeah, so basically what I feel is that the budget is kind of a populist budget, but along with that, it's more like a focus towards agrarian side of the economy as well as the taxpayers. So it's kind of like a balance between the industries as well as the individuals in the country.
Do you think it's going to be a good thing, or it's going to be a bad thing?
I kind of have a good feeling about it.
Alright, thank you so much.
So we have got very mixed kind of review, that somewhere it is politically inclined and somewhere it is focusing more on the middle class, which is like mostly the concern of the people and creates a big chunk of the population. So one of the scheme I have heard is that they are giving monetary help to the farmers, direct monetary help of around rupees 6,000. So my take on this is, rather than giving monetary help, they can help by improvising the production technique and helping them in capital intensive techniques, so that they can improve the productivity and then earn the income rather than just the limited amount of money they are getting. So that's my take on the budget.
Well, this budget 2019, according to me, is a pro-farmer budget and also a pro-middle class budget, and this may like be very beneficial in the long run for farmers. So I think it's a pro-farmer and middle class budget.
So I felt 2019 budget is beneficial for farmers and middle class people. I think it may help the farmers.
I looked at the budget which was released on 1st February 2019. What I feel about this budget is that it is a populist budget, the kind of budget you would come up with just before the elections. If you look at the kind of population it is targeting, it is A, the middle class, and B, the farmers. But if you carefully look at the kind of schemes that they have come up with to target these populations, you would understand that these schemes are more like a band-aid scheme and they would not work in the long term. They are not really sustainable. So I would say that yes, they would benefit these populations, no doubt, but in the long run we are doubtful about how good these schemes would work out. But since it's an interim budget, let's see what happens.
As you've seen, the budget has been largely perceived as one focusing on farmers and the middle class. While the upcoming elections are around the corner, the budget is largely focused on the large vote bases that are there in the country. While the overall sentiment about the budget has been positive, there are a few concerns about the fiscal math of the budget, the way the government is going to manage its revenue as well as expenditure. I think only time can tell what the impact of the budget and whether the fiscal deficit would be manageable or not. Thank you so much.